So I'd like to welcome everyone here for this Lionsgate portal opening experience. How many of you were able to partake in the cacao circle? Awesome. Well, you all should be charged up. And thank you so much for providing the cacao for everybody. Lionsgate, typically Lionsgate is done on 8-8. Well, this is 8-8 in Egypt. So we're good. So, I'd like to welcome all of you here for this experience. It's an honor and a privilege to be here and to have you all be present for this experience. If you're not familiar with this bowl up here, this is for you to set your intentions. And if, whatever intentions you may have, write them down and put it in the bowl. And it could be an intention, it could be something physical that you'd like to see transform. It could be something emotional that you would like to see shift. It could be having an amazing experience. Could be recognizing your absolute fullest potential through the Lionsgate experience. Because this is clearly the time to do that. This is clearly the time to really take in this. I mean, that's what the Lionsgate portal is all about. is that the energy is so wide open that and what brings this all about is that we're basically in the middle of the sun sign of Leo. And the star Sirius is brightest. And this goes back to early Egyptian time, the Lion's Gate. And not only, so it's a blending of the energies of the star Sirius, the lion essence of Leo, and Orion is out there. It's part of the mix along with Earth. And the way it all connects creates this portal that we talk about. And there's a significance about the 8-8 aspect of it because it's the essence of infinity. And the 8 is the essence of manifesting. And all of this energy together, it's about recognizing self, it's about self-love, and acknowledging self-love, and the empowerment. It's like reaching for your fullest empowerment. That's what the Lionsgate is all about. And this is an energy and a portal that can assist and perpetuate you into a higher vibrational energy. So that's why it's a significant time in such an, I don't want to say necessarily an important energy, but an energy that is really great for us to be able to utilize. Because we can take leaps and bounds forward through utilizing this energy. Where it would take us a level of time to do something, we can speed that up by utilizing the Lionsgate portal. And so anyway, so that's what we're all about, and that's what this energy is all about. And I was going to talk about some of the things that are coming up for holographic sound, but you know, you can look on the website and get that. You know, because there are a lot of things that are coming up. One thing I will mention is the next journey to Egypt. And I know some of you have signed up for it, and I know some of you have been. And it's a phenomenal experience, phenomenal opportunity. And those of you that have journeyed with me and otherwise can attest to that. So, can't you attest to that?
Oh, yes.
So anyway, and that's coming up. We leave on November 29th for 14 days. And so you can experience, we can carry this energy from tonight on through to that time. And there's something really interesting. You know, it's like we've heard stories and things like this, but the Lionsgate, you know, they've done, I don't remember what they call it, but where they x-ray into the earth, they've got this really fine equipment now where they can really tell things. And it's not well known that there's actually two sinkses. There's the one that we're familiar with, and then about 100 yards over, there's another one that's covered. It's a mound over, again, about 100 yards over from the one that we see. And the problem is it's got a Muslim cemetery on top of it, and they can't excavate it. But they've x-rayed it, and it's there. And so when you look at the Giza Plateau, you've got two sinkses right there, the Lionsgate. And then entering in and leading into the Great Pyramid. So it's not just stories that we hear, you know. This really is based in truth. So grab onto it and take advantage of the gift, the opportunity of this essence, of this energy that's present. So if you did get a chance to do an intention, put it in your head. And I'll ask you in a minute as we get going, I'll invite you to speak it out loud. And you don't have to yell, you know, just very softly bring it out into the physical. And there's a magic that occurs when we bring it out of the physical body into the physical of our earth. So, without further ado, any questions? Okay. So let's get into this. Will you turn those other lights on? Mm-hmm. Yourselves comfortable. If you desire to, if you want to sit on the floor or lay down, you most certainly can. Just because it's a church that we're in, it doesn't mean you can't lay down. So, whatever you're most comfortable in doing. invite you to close your eyes. Just begin to focus on your breathing. Focusing on the inhale and the exhale of your breath. Thank you. Take a couple of deep breaths. Feel your presence within your physical body. Wiggle your fingers, your toes. Flail your arms around. Be present now. And when you're ready, if you haven't already, just open your eyes. So we're about to bring lights up, so watch your eyes. Probably only mine. That's not too bad, not for y'all. So, as we finish up, I want to take a minute. I want to thank each of you for being here, for being present. Those of you that are following us online, that are streaming with us, or that will stream with us in the future, thank you for your presence, for your essence, for your vibration, for the love that you bring to this experience. Thank you. And hope to see you again. Any questions, comments, anything you'd like to share of your experience, please make a note and send it to me. I'd love to hear whatever. And again, just a reminder, we do this on a low donation basis. And that's it. So see you next time.